All right, okay. Welcome to the first Delta Blue radio episode. I'm your host, Cameron Smith, showrunner of Delta Blue, the blues punk science fiction web series coming soon to your screen. Featuring action, drama, suspense, and a mess of humor for good measure, we hope Delta Blue will engage you like no other indie web series. The Delta Blue radio show is designed to give you a special auditory flavor of the style of Delta Blue. We got some great music for you tonight and a cool guest from across the pond who will play some super cool blues music for you live tonight. But first, let's kick things off with a couple of tunes that'll set the appropriate mood. Enjoy.
For nobody in years. Wanted me some kids. Whole mess of them. But for Rose, my wife, kids is for another time. Then one spring, seemed to change in her. Breast started swelling up. A couple of moanings I heard in the bathroom throwing up. I'd done seen it in other women before, so I knew. Then one day, Rose said she had to go to Jackson, visit her folks, and she ain't want me to go, so I stayed here. You know how they talk about a woman having that glow? She ain't have it no more. She done cut it out. Got rid of it. That voice in my head, every time I think it's gone, it comes howling back. Me when I'm ailing, when I can't find my way home, lost in the pines. I calls it the Black Snake Moan.
Black Snake all in my room. Black snake all in my room. Some pretty mama better get this black snake soon.
Please keep singing.
Black snake is all I
Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Wrote the book of the seven seals. Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Well, who's that riding, John the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seven seals. You know, God walked down in the cool of the day, called Adam by his name, and he refused to answer because he's naked and ashamed. Who's that riding? John the Revelator. Who's that riding? John the Revelator. Who's that riding? John the Revelator wrote the book of the seventh seal. You know, Christ had 12 apostles and 3 he led away. Say, watch with me 1 hour till I go yon and pray. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seven seas. Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seven seas. Christ came on the Easter morning. Mary and Martha was there to see. Go tell my disciples to meet me in Galilee. Tell me who's riding, John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator. Wrote the book of the seventh seal. Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Who's that riding, John the Revelator? Tell me who's that riding, John the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seventh seal.
Hold my hand, ooh baby, it's a long way down to the bottom of the river. Hold my hand, ooh baby, it's a long way down, if you get sleep or if you get night.
The cock's gonna call in the morning, baby,
and check the cupboard for your daddy's gun.
Red sun rises like an early warning.
The Lord's gonna come for your firstborn son.
Says
where the water runs,
wash him deep where the tides are turning.
And if you fall, and if you fall, hold my hand. Ooh, baby, it's a long way down to the bottom of the river. Hold my hand. Ooh, baby, it's a long way down, a long way down. The wolves will chase you by the pale moonlight.
Drunk and driven by a tail. Some girl.
Drive your son like a railroad spy
into the water, let it pull him under.
But though you lift him, let him drown alive.
The good Lord speaks like a rolling thunder.
Let that fever make the water rise.
Let the river rise.
Ooh, all right. That was Bottom of the River, an original take on the Southern Gothic tradition of the blues by a band called Delta Ray. The chorus of the song came to one of the band's singers, Eric Holgaes, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, in a dream. I know when I come up with great ideas in my dreams, they never seem to be all that great by the time morning rolls around, so props to him. Before that, we kicked it back to one of the fathers of the blues, that was Sunhouse with John the Revelator. A song neo-blues and punk musician Jack White says is a big inspiration to him as a songwriter in his style of music. And first, it was Black Snake Moan, a cut from a film of the same name. If you recognize that voice, it's because it was none other than Sammy Jackson, who learned to play slide guitar for that role. If you recognize the song, that's because it was a cover of 1927's Black Snake Moan by Blind Lemon Jefferson, which is a cover of Black Snake Blues from 1926. Coming up, we have my interview with one of my favorite indie blues musicians, Andy Ramone, so stay tuned for that. First, we have a couple more tunes heading your way.
Death don't have no mercy in this land. Death don't have no mercy in this land. Come to your house and it won't stay long. You look in the bed, you don't find your mother gone. Death don't have no mercy. He won't give you time to get ready in the land. He won't give you time to get ready in the land. When they come to your house and they won't stay long, you look in the bed and find your father gone. He won't give you time to get ready in the land. Well, he'll leave you standing and crying in the land. He'll leave you standing and crying in the land. He'll come to your house and he won't stay long. Look in the bed, you find your sister's gone. You leave you standing crying in the land. Yeah. Takes a vacation in this land. Death never takes a vacation in this land. When it comes to your house and it won't stay long, you look in the bed, you find everybody gone. Death never takes a vacation in this land. Make your last talk now. Yeah.
Okay, first in that set was Reverend Gary Davis with Death Don't Have No Mercy. A bit more on the pessimistic side of life, if you ask me, especially coming from a reverend, but a beautiful song nonetheless. Also, the second blind blues musician we've had on so far. That was followed by one of my favorite modern musicians playing an electrifying instrumental song. That was Jack White with Highball Stepper off his new album Lazaretto, yet to be released. I particularly like Jack White because he introduces the deep blues culture to folk that might not get that opportunity on their own, something we here at Delta Blue hope to accomplish as well. Now, moving on. We have here as our first in-studio guest a lad from the UK who's a wonderful musician and caught my ear when I heard him performing his own song, Regular Blues, which I've subsequently used in a few films, not to mention the Kickstarter video for Delta Blue. Welcome to the show, Andy.
Hello.
Let's start off, what got you in the Brits so interested in the blues?
Well, me personally, it was from my dad, who was heavily into blues, rhythm and blues, rockabilly, country music, that kind of thing. And he grew up in he was like a teenager in the 70s, so this is when everyone was into Led Zeppelin and Deep Purple, sort of late 60s, early 70s. But he was more into the roots of that music, where it came from. So while his friends were getting stoned and listening to Dark Side of the Moon and Led Zeppelin albums, he was listening to Howling Wolf and all that sort of chess music, and then the Delta Blues music before it, so Robert Johnson and all the guys like that. And so when I was growing up and he started teaching me the guitar, the sort of stuff he was teaching me was blues. And then when I was a teenager, I started getting into Led Zeppelin, Jimi Hendrix, that kind of thing. But then what interested me more was where that music came from. And so it was more just a case of while I was learning the guitar, that's the sort of music I was listening to. As far as English people, Britain in general, with the blues, it was all in...
Because America, we only have so many original arts that we can claim that is our own. So why are y'all trying to steal it from us?
Well, I think you do it better than us anyway. I mean,
just greedy?
I mean, personally, I think the sort of what's known as the sort of British blues rock revival in the 60s, mainly people like Eric Clapton, the Yardbirds, and Jimmy Page and Led Zeppelin, that sort of white man blues that they revived, it's not actually something I like that much, and I much prefer pretty much any blues music past about 1958. I don't really listen to that much because it doesn't feel authentic to me. So I mean, someone like Eric Clapton being the sort of the main person who introduced it to Britain, I don't actually listen to any Eric Clapton stuff. I really don't like him. So I think really, as far as blues music goes, like genuine, it needs to be genuine and authentic, and that usually comes from what everyone, what was being done in Memphis and Mississippi in the sort of 50s and before that.
Now, Mr. Ramone is kind enough, and he's going to play a song or a few for us tonight. What you going to play for us first now, coming up right now?
I'll play this song. It's the first song I wrote when I got my new resonator guitar, which I got a couple of months ago. I called it Train My Blues, and I mean, like I said, I don't sing, so there's no lyrics or anything, so I just make up the titles based on what they sound like, and it sounds a bit like a train, but it's mainly influenced from a guitarist called Booker White and a singer, who's one of my favourites, and he does this thing, which I'll do in the song, and it's sort of a percussive slapping roll thing that he does where he's bashing the guitar about. And I sort of wrote it trying to imitate that, but I'll just play it for you now really quickly. Thank you.
Well, that was just dandy.
Thanks.
So, you mentioned, talking about the blues and where you came and what you were learning when you were learning guitar. A lot of people use the blues to teach themselves how to play guitar, and you would think that would make it kind of simplistic, and it really is if you strip it all down. But the way you play it, and the way a lot of the masters play it, seemed to add a lot of fancy bits to it. Like, could you talk a little bit about that? How it can be a little easy, and it can be wildly complicated.
Yeah, well, it can be as easy or as complicated as you want it to be. I suppose the standard blues thing is the what's known as the sort of 1-4-5 progression, which is like the foundation of blues and rock and roll and rock and sort of popular music in general. But if you listen to especially some of the really old guys from the 30s and 40s or even before, they're playing 1-4-5, but they're not playing it, you know, what's called a 12 bar blues, I suppose. It isn't necessarily being played 12 bars, they're stretching bits, they're adding bits in, and it's more about, it's almost things like chord changes and stuff, it's almost inconsequential to the music, because the sort of the genuine Delta blues music is more about what they're singing about and the feeling, you know, the sort of the history and the gravity behind what they're singing about. But it's more that the blues is more like a foundation for everything that came after it, really. And it's sometimes listening to it, it's not even just wanting to listen to good music, it's educational, it's learning about where the music that you like today came from, and it's progressing it back, and I find that sort of side of it quite fascinating, really. Really, what the blues really is sort of the original stuff, is there's a lot of hardship and history behind where that music came from and what they're singing about, and I think it needs to be genuine for me. If you're putting, you know, if you're actually a sort of blues musician, and you know, sort of, I mean, if you take things like, I mean, generally speaking, sort of a modern day blues music, it doesn't quite feel authentic enough to me. Something like the White Stripes, they kind of get it right because it's simple and it's, you know, and it's raw and it's authentic enough to work as blues music. But it's, I mean, someone like the White Stripes, they're more than just blues anyway.
Well, can we pull another song out of you?
Yeah. Okay, so I'll do one that I think I call it Stop Star Blues. It's a sort of a Sunhouse style song with a lot of sort of, it might be quite loud again. So I'll just play it really quickly. I'll do the short version. Thank you.
sweeter than a June bug rolling around in a bowl full of jelly.
Thanks.
So, what do you, in your opinion, what all can apply to creating a song out of that's defined as the blues?
I'd certainly think it has to be completely original. I mean, the thing about blues in general, especially if you sort of go back and study it, it's most of the blues guys were borrowing and stealing what they were doing from other people anyway, and it's sort of a murky area of who wrote what, and a lot of old blues music doesn't really have sort of copyright protection. A lot of it's public domain because they're traditional songs or field songs that have been amalgamated into real songs. It doesn't even necessarily have to come down to the chords you're doing it. I think actually primarily blues, it's what you're singing and playing about that define it. You know, generally speaking, blues would be seem to be sad music, you're feeling blue, that kind of thing. But there's just a huge amount of history and sort of gravity behind that music that I think is what defines it as well. That's just what they're playing.
All right, so let's do a simple question. What are you playing on? What do you like to play on?
Okay, so I've got a resonator guitar, which I've only recently bought. I've never had a resonator before, so I've always played sort of slide guitar blues on just a normal acoustic. But a resonator guitar is what was primarily played in the 30s and 20s, 30s and 40s before electric guitars and amplification were invented. So it's a sort of standard acoustic guitar, but it's got a resonator cone in the body which amplifies it a bit more, and so it creates a sound that you'd mostly associate with things like the blues or country music or any kind of music from that era before the 50s. But yeah, that's what I'm playing, we've sort of been playing on, and it just gives it a bit more of a, well, it's easier to play slide guitar on it just because it's got a higher action on it, and it just gives a bit more of an authentic sound.
Well, I thank you for joining me, Mr. Andy Ramone. You want to play us out?
Yeah, I'll do one more song, just give me a sec.
What's this one?
This one, oh, I can't remember if I even gave it a name. I don't think I did. This one's sort of more of a, rather than a sort of Delta Blues thing, it's more based on Muddy Waters from the sort of 50s, say sort of Chess Records, that kind of era. Although I haven't got a backing band, obviously. But I'll just do it really quickly. Thank you.
and gentlemen. Thank y'all for joining us. And thank you, Andy Ramone. Is there any place anybody can find you if they want to listen to your music?
Actually, the main place to be would be Hit Record. Would be hitrecord.org/users/AndyRamone.
And I'll make sure and post the link on the info for this. So all you can check that out, give him a listen, and fall right in love with the blues. And thanks, Andy Ramone.
Thanks for having me.
Well, that was Mr. Andy Ramone. Again, you can catch him on hitrecord.org/user/AndyRamone. Hit Record being the open collaboration website started by Mr. Joseph Gordon-Levitt. Coming up now is
attention listeners of the Delta Blue Pirate Radio Station. This program is in violation of the Capital Corporation.
You aren't even real.
And subject to immediate termination.
I guess I gotta wrap up.
Hello. Welcome to the Capital Corporation's newest radio program, program M0N3Y. Please enjoy one of our favorite songs from the President and CEO's personal collection.
Old Abe, he's in the White House, he's a-taking of us new. Old Grant, he's a-bustin' his gut with the booze. We're out a-wading snow and we ain't got no shoes. We'll keep a-marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll keep marching on. Winter is a-coming, it's a-getting mighty cold. Winter is a-coming, it's a-getting mighty cold. Soon all the generals will be crawling in their holes. We'll keep a-marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll keep marching on. Every time you shoot a rebel, there's one thing for sure. Every time you shoot a rebel, there's one thing for sure. Every time you shoot a rebel, up'll jump a dozen more. We'll keep marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll keep marching on. Old Abe, he freed the colored man. Glory, hallelujah. Old Abe freed the colored man, glory hallelujah. Wish to my Lord he would free me too, then I'd go marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll keep marching on. I can't hardly tell. They tell us we are winning. I can't hardly tell. For I know at Chickamauga that they shot us all to hell, but we kept marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll keep marching on.